Hi guys, thank you for watching, and in this video we are going to cover about the slots. So we are into the part environment, so right now we need to choose a fundamental plane, and then we are going to go into the ribbon section of the sketch tab menu. So here you can see under the parallelogram there is an option for the straight slot. So if you I'm going to go into the drop down menu, so you can see there are different options like straight slot, center point, straight slot, 3-point arc slot, center point, arc slot. So let's start with the straight slot. So for the straight slot, what you need to do is you just need to select a point, and then wherever you want, like wherever you want to drag, and then you need to click it again, and then you can just, you need to move your mouse outwards, and then in this way you can control the size of the slot. Suppose I want to have this size, and here into the feature manager you can see there are different kind of slots. So if you want, this one was the straight slot, and again there are different points. If you are going to bring your cursor on them, so it's going to show you this is center point, straight slot, this is 3-point, this is again center point. And there is another option which is add dimensions. So if you want to add dimensions, so there are two different ways to add the dimension, so you can choose whatever the way you want. So I'm just going to check it. So now and after, if I'm gonna draw a slot, it's automatically gonna add the dimensions. So let's go and let's start another type of slot. Let's start the center point straight slot. Okay, center point, so it's gonna be start from the center, so I can click it anywhere, and then you can see from the center I have this, the length of the slot on the both sides. I need to click it again, and then I need to drag my cursor outwards, so wherever I want to move. And if I'm going to drop it, so it's going to give me the dimensions as well, because I already checked the dimensions checkbar as well. So this is the way, in this way I can give dimensions as well. And now if you want to change the dimensions, what you can do is you can just double click on it, and it's 51, let's say 60 mm, and let's click the green check mark. So in this way it's going to be changed in the same into another direction. Sorry for distraction, but if you think my videos are helpful for you, or if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, then I'm gonna highly recommend you can go into the description of this video, and you would find a link of my course where I have over 10 hours of videos in which I have explained each and every command in a very detailed video. Or if you have any projects or assignments, so feel free to write me on my email, which is given into the description of this video. Thank you. Or there is another option which I'm going to show with the next thing. Okay, let's go with the 3-point arc slot. Okay, so 3-point, I need to choose 3 points and arc. So it's going to made an arc first. First, this is the point, first point. This is the second point. And now I need to drag top or down or wherever or in whatever shape I want to have my slot. So suppose I want to draw it at the radius of, let's say 34. Okay, it's 35. Okay, let's say 35, and then I need to drag my cursors, drag my mouse outwards, and in this way it's gonna follow that sketch and it's gonna draw a slot for me. And there is another option into the feature manager, the really interesting option. If I want to change this slot as a construction, so I just need to click it, and then it's going to be converted into the construction geometry. And the second thing is, if you don't want to have these dimensions, you just need to uncheck this add dimensions and click the green check mark. So from now and on, if you are going to draw any slot, so it's not going to give the dimensions automatically. Okay, this was the third. So let's go and let's see the last option, which is center point arc slot. Okay, you need to draw a arc, and then it's gonna draw a slot on that. So first you are gonna select your center point. Suppose I want to from center from this point, and then I wanna move till here. So this is controlled by the center point, right? And then wherever I want, suppose I want to have this much radius, let's say this much, and now I need to just drag my mouse outwards, and in this way I can control and I can draw my slot. Okay, again, these are the things, these are all the types which we already covered. So you can switch between these types by just pressing A on your keyboard. Look at that. So you are just gonna move into different type of slots. Okay, then I'm gonna click the green check mark. But there is one more interesting and cool stuff which I want to show you. So you can create, this was the tool for the slots, but you can create these slots with the line command as well. So let's go and let's select the line command. I'm gonna select line command. I'm just gonna made a line here. Let's made a line here, and then Although we did not cover it till now, but there is an option for the offset entities. So what I'm going to do is we are going to cover this in very detail in future videos, but I just want to use it to create our slot. So I'm going to select the offset entities. So you can see by using this command, it's going to create an offset of this line into this direction. So here into the option, you can see the first thing is parameters, how much wide you want to have offset. So this is 10 mm right now. You can change if you want to have 20, 30, whatever. And this is just into the one direction. So there could be an option for bidirectional. As you can see, this is the option for bidirectional. So if you want to have offset on the both directions, then you can check bidirectional here. And there is one more option. If you want to have a cap ends, you just need to click cap ends. And in this way, it's going to draw your slot. And then I'm going to click the green check mark. Look at that. So in this way, what we can do is we can create slot. So there are a bunch of options to create your slot. So the good practice is you can use the tools, or other thing is you should know all other ways. So in this way, in some scenarios, this is going to help you a lot. And that's all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one. And if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, then don't forget to check the course link in the description. Thank you.